Welcome to this session on Application Monitoring in OutSystems. In this session, we're going to look at a number of different things that can be monitored. We'll see that Service Center has a number of analytics that can be returned to us with different types of reports and daily history. We'll see that Lifetime has analytics from the environment level to the application module all the way down to the screen action level, where we can begin to get a real idea of the overall end-user experience. And then we'll also look at how to enable these lifetime analytics. So if we look at the Service Center analytics to begin with, Service Center provides a few different reports out of the blocks. It has an hourly and daily activity report, a number of different resource reports, and a top errors report. These reports can be generated on demand at any specific date interval that you would like, and they provide a consolidated view of the information based on the type of report that you're doing. To access these reports, you would log into Service Center, go to the Analytics tab, and then go to the Reports area. Inside the Reports, you just need to choose the type of report and the interval that you're looking for. Once you create and generate the report, you can then download it, and it remains on the server unless you need to get rid of it. So inside of Lifetime, analytics are done a little differently. Lifetime is collecting and displaying analytics and not generating specific reports, but it's constantly gathering information about the end user experience of all the applications. So if we log into Lifetime, there is an analytics area. And in that analytics area, we can then begin to select different things to get more information about the performance that we're looking for. So we can look at analytics for different environments. Here we're looking at the production environment. We can look at the overall end user experience, but we could also focus on the client side, the network, or the server side. We could focus on all the applications or one specific application and get some of its overall performance feedback, like response time and response breakdown, so that we know what's going on in different areas. As we're gathering this information, we can specify a specific time area and even filter by overall response time to get a better idea and to get more specific information back from Lifetime. So in the application information area, there is a performance index called AppDex. AppDex measures the user satisfaction with the performance of an application. It rates applications from 0 to 100, and it assumes that speed is something that the user is looking for. If you get a score of 0 to 70%, that's considered poor user experience. 70 to 85%, you would be getting fair user experience, and 85 to 100 is good user experience and what we're looking for. It calculates this number by saying that if a page load takes less than 2 seconds, then it's considered fast and that's a good thing. If it takes between 2 and 8 seconds, that's somewhat slow and isn't good, but if it's more than 8 seconds, it's really slow and that is definitely going to cause bad experience for the end user. So if you're interested in learning more about the AppDex score, because it is shown on every level for the performance information that we're looking at, you can check out the information in the success area of our documentation. So if we start at the very top, we do have application analytics. So we're looking at a particular environment, we can see all of the different applications. If we select a specific application, then what happens is the application gets moved to the top. So now we can see that from analytics we're in production, and we're now looking at the Field Services app. We can see its icon, we can see the modules that are inside the Field Services app, we get the Field Services AppDex score, and we see its specific response time and response breakdown. We can also see for things like applications and modules what might be getting slower. So it begins looking at different resources, and not just how fast they're responding, but how fast they've been responding over time, and if there is a particular trend. So here we can see that the Field Services app has some good responses and a lot of fair responses, and then even a few slow responses. So if we begin drilling down inside of Field Services, we could click on the module, and then that module would give us all of the detailed information about the module. So here we can see the Telecom Services module, and inside that module there are multiple screens. In the performance area, we're still getting the AppDex score for the module. We're seeing its different response time and its overall breakdown. But now, what we could do is select a particular screen. So it seems like the product list and the dashboard are both performing fairly poorly, so we can drill down into those and look at them even more. Once we've selected the dashboard screen, drilling down to that level then shows us all of the screen actions that are available in the dashboard screen. The preparation is run as the first part of generating the screen itself and beginning to render the screen, but that preparation seems to be the one that's causing the problem. The rest of the actions seem to be running just fine and not having any problems, and again we can see the dashboard's overall performance here. And if we wanted to, once we get down to the actual preparation, we can see how well the preparation is performing from an AppDex and response time perspective. Once we get down to the action level, we can't get any lower, so we'd have to go back to the dashboard screen because we've now drilled down from the production level environment through the application to the module to the screen to the actions in the screen. So this shows you can get analytics on any part of the range of things that are executing on the server. Now, we may want to be able to control more of this end user experience because in general, it aggregates all of the information from both the client side, what happens on the network, and what happens on the server side. So these metrics can allow us to kind of look and try to find and do some troubleshooting on the performance information that we're seeing. And as we just saw, lifetime is going to allow us to drill down inside of the applications, but we can also drill down in the areas of the application. So if we wanted to, we could just look at the client information, or just look at the network or the server information. But to understand that a little better, how would these be calculated? Well, if we look at the full request response lifecycle, in step one, the client makes the request to the server. And then in step two, the server gets that request, and then the server starts beginning to do the work to get a response. In step three, the server starts sending the response, and the client may actually begin receiving it. And in step five, the server is done and has completed sending the response. It will continue flowing over the network until step six, where the client receives the last byte of the response, and then once it has that response, it may take a little bit of extra time to render the rest of that response. So there are a number of different measurements that can be made here. On the client side, there is the time to the first byte versus the time to the last byte of the response. There is the load time from when it started getting the response to actually fully rendering the response. And if you add both of these first two together, you get the full duration it took for the client from the moment it made the request till it fully got its response rendered. There's also the information of how long things took on the server side. So we can get an idea of how long things take on the server side, how long things are taking overall on the client side, and then we get an idea of how things are happening on the network as well. So all of these key points are being measured so that we have the capability of knowing where in the overall lifecycle some of these performance problems could be occurring. So when we look at client analytics, we can get overall client performance, and we can get information about the types of browsers and the types of operating systems that our users are using. When we need more information about the network, we can get the overall network performance. We can get the idea of the type of networks our users are using and the actual carriers themselves that are providing the service. And from there, we can get server analytics. And those server analytics will show us the server performance, the server time distribution, and the server time breakdown. And for all of the different things that are occurring on the server, we can see the different types of slow calls that are occurring and what types of resources are making those slow calls. Now, when we think about lifetime analytics, this seems pretty cool, But to get all of that information, there must be a number of different measurements being made, and that could actually affect overall performance. By default, lifetime analytics is enabled in the production environment, so we have all of that information available. You can enable it for other environments, like the QA environment, by going to the Analytics tab. When we go to Analytics, we can choose a particular environment, and when we look at the environment monitoring status, we can turn it on or off for production, on or off for quality, and on and off for development. Because we may not wish to monitor everything if we know certain applications are behaving fairly well and they've been very well tested, we can also turn on or off analytics on an application basis. So by default, all applications will be monitored, but we could go through and take certain applications and disable their monitoring. So we looked at a lot of different types of application monitoring, from the service center side to spending a lot of time looking at how lifetime can allow us to go from the environment level all the way down to the action level and monitor everything that's going on. So hopefully you enjoyed and learned a lot in application monitoring. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.